There's a language family in Ghana. It's called Akan, the Akan family, which is legend has it that it's sort of the original family that spoke this Akan language. But as they grew, as their population grew and things, they needed to sort of find new land and find new space to live. And so Ghana has a number of languages that branched off of the Akan, the original Akan language. So Chi is one of those branches, or Fanti. Fanti is another branch which they speak in Cape Coast, down in the south. But they're really close. So, like, if you have a Chi speaker and a Fanti speaker, they'll understand each other, even though he'll speak.
Okay, I remember the time when I entered Ghana new. In those days, almost all the streets when I enter, I'll be seeing white people walking around, sipping, and I know, like, white people are so common in Ghana, walking freely, and like, they are all safe, they are walking. And since then, I begin noticing, but this can't end. It can't happen in Nigeria. Oh, no, it can't happen in Nigeria. You can't see white people walking around like the way white people are free in Ghana, walking like they are so, like, almost everywhere. They are so, like, they are so lovely. Ghanaians are so lovely. That is what I see. Okay, you can continue the video.
She and he'll speak Fante, they can have a conversation because they're relatively similar. They have the same root language. Even though they're pretty different to the ear, they can understand each other very well, especially fluently. Because me, I wasn't fluent in Chi, and so they sounded quite different to me. But to their ears, it was enough that they could communicate, which is what I'm saying. And there's other Akan languages like Bono and different things. They can all sort of understand each other. But Chi is the biggest Akan language, like the most population of speakers in Ghana. And they say that the Akans came out of the Senegal area, which is way west coast Africa, sort of by the Gambia over there. That there's a tribe over there that kind of came down the west coast, came into what is today Ghana, and they sort of settled there. And so that's the history. They don't know, African history isn't very well recorded. They have a really hard time keeping records, but that's like mouth to mouth, at least. That's the legend behind it. But with Chi, it's a very simple language. It's written language too. I learned how to read it, but I didn't always know what I was saying because they use English letters, but there are certain letters that aren't included, and there are some letters that are excluded from English, and they just pronounce it differently. So like we say A, they say ah, and we're B and they be. So A, B, C, D, E. It's very like eh. Lots of eh. And the two letters they have that we don't have is oh and eh. So oh is like a backward C. So there's O and then there's oh. So that's how you pronounce it. Then there's E, and then there's eh, which is like a backwards, it's kind of like a three. Yeah. It's like rounded around backwards. No, not even backwards three, a normal three. Yeah. And you pronounce it eh. So they have a phrase etisang, which is like how are you? Etisang. And that eh sound is the three. The eh. I don't know how to explain it. But like I said before, since we're not allowed, missionaries weren't allowed to teach the Chi speakers who didn't speak English. And so very few missionaries learn it fluently because there's very little incentive. I mean, even if you learn it, we weren't allowed to teach in it. So even if you could speak it fluently, it was sort of against mission rules to teach in Chi if the person didn't speak English. And so a lot of missionaries wouldn't learn it fluently, but they would learn it enough to communicate with everybody. But the Ghanaians love it when you do speak their language. When you speak Chi to them, they feel this a kinship towards the missionaries. You know, it's easier to get in their houses. It's easier talk to them. They, even though Ghanaians are the friendliest people you'll meet on earth, really. Even within Africa, people say Africans are friendly. Ghana's sort of the epitome of friendly Africa, the friendliest people. But then speaking their language just makes it that much.
You see how white people confidently talking about Ghana? Wow, Ghana really the destinations that everybody need. Yes, that is what I'm saying. Because if the white people are saying it, Ghana is the best destination that they need, then what about we African? That mean there is the blessing of God upon Ghana. We African, we are not saying it. That is what I'm saying it because of how white people they are talking about Ghana. And any when you see them coming to Ghana, they are excited and they are safe. Nothing harm them. When they come to Ghana safely and they will return safely and they keep praising Ghana. This is wonderful. Listening to him again.
Better for them. And I
Genza.
mentioned one is etisseng, which is how are you? And the response would be eye, which means like I'm fine. Or another response to that would be bokol, which is like cool, I'm cool, everything's cool. Another common one is wodindiseng, which is what is your name? And the response would be Medinde Seth or whatever. If you're an elder, my name was Elder Taylor, and you have to say it sort of in their accent. So it'd be Medinde Elder Taylor. So the ERs, they don't have er. They don't pronounce. They think it's really difficult, and so ER ends up sounding like an A, like an So it'd be Elder Taylor was my name. So Medinde Elder Taylor. My name's Elder Taylor. Wufrihing. It means, this sounds funny, huh? Wufrihing is like, where are you from? And you'd say, Mifri US or Mifri Ghana or wherever you're from. Iyeye it's we are missionaries. Iyeye, we are, and then Nsempakafwo is missionaries. So we are missionaries. That's sometimes how we'd introduce ourselves to people. So yeah, those are just a couple phrases from Chi. Sounds kind of funny. And my accent sounds funny, I'm sure. But that's how they say it. A lot of Americans, when they go, they'll speak Chi but with like an American accent, and it just doesn't sound as authentic. So if you go and you try to learn their language, listen to them really closely and try to move your mouth the way they move their mouth, or try to sound the way that they sound. Because it's not just about saying the word, but saying it the way that they say it. And it becomes really meaningful to them.
I hope you enjoy the video. What do you really learn from this video? Do you learn something? What particular thing do you learn? Because you know, as I said, when I come to Ghana, those days, and I was new in Ghana, and I was seeing white people walking around almost everywhere in Ghana, like they are free. It's not like they are moving with bodyguard or security or police. No, they're just walking, they are free. And I'm not again asking myself because I know where I'm coming from. It cannot happen. It's not just Accra, almost everywhere in Ghana, you see. And if you think I'm lying as you are watching my video, I'm going to be bringing it. Where white people around like northern side of Ghana, Kumasi, the place, I'll be bringing video for you so that you'll be seeing it if you think I'm lying to you. Yes, I'm going to be doing bringing you white people video to see how it's be. God bless you. Subscribe and leave your comment behind. Share this video to more people so that we're about to bring you more video. I don't even know what to talk. Bye bye. Bye bye, bye bye, bye bye, bye.